Good morning, Stephen Whiteside here with your daily market outlook for Monday, August 15th, 2011. In the pre-market this morning, we do have stock index futures above fair value, but they're really not enough to turn anybody's head. So Monday is historically the best performing day of the week, and with the volatility we had last week, I thought we would have seen a little bit more buying in the pre-market on Monday morning. Well, we've got a nice setup here. We had panic selling last week, as you know, and we traded down through the bottom of the panic zones. We've got a pressure zone forming. That's the time and place when we like to look for buy signals. Now, so far, we're still having trouble at resistance here Thursday, Friday, and it looks like Monday morning we're having trouble around the 1187.50 level on the S&P 500 cash index. If we move up here, we've got a nice band of resistance at the 1260 level. So we've got a lot of hurdles to get to 1260. I don't think it's going to be easy, and I think that's where the market will top out if we can get a rally here. Looking at the weekly price target chart, we traded right through the 1125 level last week and quickly reversed, got down just over 1100. If we break down below 1125, then 1000 is our next target to the downside for the S&P 500 cash index. Now, one of the most bullish things that happened last week is that resistance for the VIX held, and we had a bearish reversal week for the VIX, and we also saw some money flow back into technology, and we like to watch the technology sector. It's a leadership group. So the NASDAQ 100, the NASDAQ Composite, the SOX index all generated bullish reversal weeks. And we also had bullish reversal week for the Dow Jones Trucking Index and railroads. We also had a lot of bullish reversal weeks for the iShares for a lot of the countries around the world. So it's not just the U.S. that had bullish reversal weeks last week. And I think that could be positive for the market going forward. Now, the problem here is that we've had trouble at resistance at the 1187.50 level. We clustered around there on Thursday and Friday. We were not able to break out. We were all the way down at 1101.54. If you blinked, you missed it. But certainly there are buyers down there at the 1100 level, and that would be a major level to break through if we do head back down. Looking upward again, we got stuck at mathematical resistance on Thursday and Friday. If we break out above that, then we've got a band of resistance. The hourly flypaper channel is in the 1210-1220 level. Now, just looking at some numbers from last week, the high was up at 1198, low was down at 1101. We closed at 1178, and that's 20 points away from the high. It's also 9 points away from the 1187.50 level, and I think that's about where we're going to start trading on Monday morning. So we'll have to see if we can hold above that level and make it up to test last week's high, which is 1198.48. If we can break out above last week's high, then 1275 is our next target. And of course, that comes right in the flypaper channel. The most important number to watch on Monday is we want to be bullish on the U.S. stock market as long as we remain above the 1168.40 level. If we start breaking down below that, I think there's a good chance we could run back down and test last week's lows. Taking a look at commodities, no changes to worry about on Monday. We've got crude oil trading in the channel. We've got gasoline trading in the channel. The natural gas had traded up to the upper channel line 2 days in a row. Close above 413.50 would give us a buy signal. For copper, inside day on Friday. For gold, still looking for a pullback here, still on a buy signal. And no change for silver, still on a sell signal as of Friday's close. Looking at index charts, they all pretty well look the same for the VIX. So we traded into the channel last Friday. We need to start seeing a close below 29.84 to give us a new daily sell signal. And that would probably correspond with a new daily buy signal. These breakout points that we're looking at here are going to continue to decline very sharply over the next couple of days. So we're not going to wait all week to get above 1228.60. That's just the number for Monday. And 2247.30 is the number for the NASDAQ 100. Of course, that's going to continue to move lower. 740.03 for the Russell, 2347.40 for the ZAX, 118.58 for the S&P Bank Index. They're all looking pretty well the same down the lower channel line here for the energy sector. For the chip sector, we were looking pretty good last week. The market had an inside day, and the chip sector closed above the previous day's high last week, and that told us that there was more money flowing back into chips. So 367.77, that would give us a buy signal, close above that. Gold, the gold stocks were pretty pretty steady the last couple of days. Not expecting a lot out of this sector anytime soon. For the XAU, for transports, down at the lower channel line. No change for the euro, no change for the U.S. dollar, still on a buy signal. No change for the 30-year bond, a close below 131.57, would change things on Monday. For Monday's roadmap, we were oversold. We're trying to get up here. We had an early warning signal, ran into resistance. Certainly projecting higher prices here into that band of 1210 to 1220, 1218.75. That's our mathematical target. Pros took control last week, and of course that helped start the rally that we're currently on. And again, my big number for Monday is 1168.40. When we look at the VIX, when you see the S&P 500 on a buy signal, you expect the VIX on a sell signal, which is certainly the case. And so as long as the VIX stays below 37.60 on Monday, we should see higher stock prices. Last up, just a 60-minute look at the VIX once again using the flypaper channel. You can see that we're trading above it. What we want to do is start to slice through the flypaper channel, and it's at that point where you start to see things change on the daily chart. So we still got a ways to go on the downside for the VIX. Okay, that's all for Monday morning, folks. We're looking at resistance at the 1187.50 level. We're looking at resistance at just under 1200. If we can get above that, then we should see a rally up to the 1260, 1280 level on the S&P 500, which would be a very nice rally for the rest of the stock market. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Tuesday morning.